So today in our lesson, sixth graders, we're going to talk about powers of numbers. The power of a number. And when a number is written as a power, it's written with an exponent in it. Okay? The exponent is a little number that tells you how many times you would multiply the base, which is the big number, times itself. When the little number is a 3, we call that cubed. And what it means is you would multiply the number, let's say the number of the base is 5, you multiply 5 times itself 3 times. So you do 5 times 5 times 5. If it said 5 to the second power, you can read that as 5 squared, because squared means to the second power. 5 squared means 5 times 5. Again, it's the big number times itself, and there are 2 times. 5 times 5. So 5 times 5 is 25. 5 squared is 25. Then there's a rule that I want you to know. There's a math rule that says any number to the 0 power is equal to 1. The answer is 1. So if you see this, 5 to the 0 power. 5 to the 0 power, it's not 5. That would actually be 5 to the first power. 5 to the 0 power is just 1. The answer is 1. It's just a rule, okay? 7 to the 0 power is 1. 3 to the 0 power is 1. N to the 0 power is 1. What is N? N stands for any number. Okay? So we can write this, and this is true. Any number to the 0 power is 1. You can say any letter to the 0 power is 1. A to the 0 power is 1, B to the 0 power is 1, X to the 0 power is 1. Okay? Look at this example. 4 squared. Does 4 squared equal 8?
No.
What's the mistake in this? 4 squared equals 8. Does it equal 8? What's the mistake? This is a common mistake. Adam?
They were doing 4 times 2.
Yeah.
So you have to do 4 times 4.
Correct. You don't do 4 times 2. You don't multiply the base times the exponent. You multiply the base times itself. So you do 4 times 4. And the answer is 16. So 4 squared equals 16. Okay? Questions now? Alyssa?
Is there a way to show the answer like n to the power of 5?
Yeah. Not today, no. No, you get into that later on when you get into algebra. But right now we're just learning about what exponents do. Shania? Under equals, oh, the line through the equal sign? That means not equal to. If you see a line through the equal sign, it means not equal to. So 4 squared is not equal to 8. That's what that means. Tim? Yeah, do this then when you're raising your hand. That way I know what you're referring to.
So I just have a hunch. So if it was 5 to the power of negative 1, would it be 1 time?
Yeah. Yep.
And
it
then
is.
If it kept on going, you would go to 1/25th.
Right.
And then 1/25th.
Right. So next year, And more when we get into advanced algebra, you'll work with negative exponents, but not right now.
Are we going to do that this year?
Okay.
Next year.
Next year and the year after. Let's look at some examples here. Let's see how exponents are used to write numbers. So, you can write big numbers using exponents. And the reason being, because our number system is organized in what we call base 10. So I'll show you how this works. Write this down. 10 to the 0 power. What would 10 to the 0 power equal? Darren?
1.
1. How about 10 to the 1st power? 10?
1. Okay, that's 10.
10. 10 to the 2nd power. Myra?
20?
No, that would be if you multiply the base times the exponent. But this is 10 times 10. What would 10 times 10 be? 100. Good. How about 10 to the 3rd power? Kevon?
10,000.
Close. How many zeros would it have? See if you can see a pattern now.
I know.
Look at how many zeros. How many zeros does 10 to the 2nd power have? So look at this. 10 to the 2nd power has how many zeros?
2.
So 10 to the 3rd power should have? You mean 3.
Yeah.
But one, the answer is 1,000.
Yeah.
Yep. And 10 to the 4th power has?
4, and it's 10,000.
So it's 10,000. All right. You see the pattern? Okay. Now, another way to write this. And we looked at this in the very one of the very first lessons. We wrote ones, tens, hundreds. What are these?
Numbers?
No. Remember when we had numbers written in here? And then the 10,000s. And then the 100,000. So if we have a number like 6? Calvin?
1.
6 ones. 2. Tens, 4, hundreds. Yep.
Yep.
Now, let's take this information and put it in here, in this chart. So, how can we write ones? As a power of 10. How can we write 1 as power of 10? Trevor?
You'll put a 1 in the top right corner.
Yeah, this is, well, it's 10 to the 0 power, isn't it?
Oh.
The 1's place is 10 to the 0 power. If we put these in here, the 1's place is 10 to the 0 power. And the 10's place is what? Which one of these? Leo?
10 to the
1st
power.
And the 100's place is?
10
to the 2nd power.
And then on and on.
And then on and on. 10 to the 3rd power. 10 to the 4th power. 10 to the 5th power. You see how these fit the places? Because this is the 1's place. This is the tens place.
This
is the hundreds place. This is the thousands place. This is the 10,000s place. You see that pattern? That's why we call our number system the base 10 system. Because this is the base and this is the exponent. What's the base? 10. It's base 10. Okay? That also means that we can write these digits. The value of these digits using a power. And we write it in expanded form, kind of like you wrote 300,000 plus 50,000 plus 2,000 plus 400 plus 20 plus 6. Do you remember when you wrote out the number in expanded form?
Yeah.
You remember when we did that? We could write out any number in expanded form using exponents. So watch how we do this. 3 times 10 to the fifth power. What's 3 times 10 to the fifth power? I'll give you a hint, it's on the chart. What's the value of 3 times 10 to the fifth power?
10 is 50?
No, would we multiply the base times the exponent? No. What is the value of 10 to the fifth power? 10 to the fifth power equal? Keep on. 300,000, right? Yeah.
I knew it.
And that's what this three is worth, is 300,000. What is 5 times 10 to the fourth power worth? Kelvin?
10,000.
10,000 times 5, which is?
5,000.
50,000. It's the value of the 5. It's the value of this 5 in the number, right?
Yes.
And what's the value of the 2? How can you write the value of the 2 in expanded form? So start with writing 2, and then times 10, and what place is this? What place is this? Amelia? The thousands place. So,
I didn't like that at all.
Write it. Oh, that was you.
Yeah.
Couldn't tell it was you.
I'm trying to figure out, I'm trying to figure out my phone. And so Miss Bonnie said, try pressing intercom and then the extension. And intuitively I thought, that doesn't make sense. And then when it was on the
intercom,
I didn't want to do that.
No problem. So what is 10 to the third? What place is that?
Thousands.
The thousands place. And this is worth 2,000. So instead of writing 2,000, we can write 2 times 10 to the third. And what would we write for the 4? 4 times 10 to the
second
power. Because the value of the 4 is what? What's the value of this 4 in the number? Come on, people. We did this before in one of our first lessons. What's the value of the 4? Sam?
400.
So instead of writing 400, we could write it as 4 times 10 to the second power.
Oh.
Yeah, that's a 2. My pen just stopped working. Okay. And then what's the 6 word?
Shh.
Thomas?
Ones.
6 ones. So instead of writing 6, you can write it in exponent form by writing 6 times 10 to the 0 power. Because that means the ones place. Okay? That's how you write this in exponential form or expanded form using exponents. Okay. 3 times whatever the place is. 3 times 10 to the 5th. 5 times 10 to the 4th because 5 is worth 50,000. 2 times 10 to the 3rd because the 2 is worth 2,000. 4 times 10 to the 2nd because the 4 is worth 400. Okay. Now you're going to practice this in your assignment. Your assignment starts on page 21. And I want you to do 2 through 34 evens. 2 through 34 evens.
Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Actually, I'm going to change that to 2 through 30 evens. 2 to 30 evens. Page 21, 2 to 30 evens. Now, for numbers 2 and 4, you get to use your calculator.
For problems, which ones?
2 and 4.
2 and 4?
Yes.
So we don't need to show which ones?
Okay. 20 minutes.
21 and 22. 21 and 22. Start on 21.
Just you.